awful big lost and found under the circumstances. That gator's a crazy gal, but so is the gal who promised to look after her.
Wait, I got an ankle gator to follow me?
Never could ask for a song. They said Queen Anne was just a folktale. Now there's living proof she ain't. Sample Zia's famous cooking.
Kappa, kappa, kappa.
He wolfs down too much too fast, and it all goes to his head.
I'm happy now, yeah, thanks.
I've said a lot about the kid, but he ain't the only one wrapped up in all this. What's he thinking? Well, let me see if I got this straight. I only heard it once. Once there was a normal Ura girl, but she wasn't born in the Tazzle terminals like the rest of her people. She was from Ceylonia. Inside the city, on condition they would never return to the terminals. Ura refugees who came into the city had to stay for life. It was a way to reduce the risk of city secrets leaking out.
God, what are these? Bastards. I'll stop shooting at you. They're like Torbjorn's turret.
Mama passed away from birthing complications, leaving the girl trapped inside that city with no one but her father. Father was sharper than a brusher's pike, so he got a job working for the city's mancers. His daughter barely saw him.
Oh no, I didn't mean to pick that up.
Father told her nothing of her Ura heritage. He told her nothing of the Mancers. It's for your own good, he said. She took to studying the arts, learned more through music than history books. Gained a knack for strings and songs. First, she tried to be like other girls, but her classmates spread word that her father was an Ura trader, selling out the city. One young man stood up for her, or so he led her to believe. He knew much of her heritage, and she grew fond of him.
This thing just died already. Oh my god. You motherfucker.
To take him to a family den to meet a father. Spoke of how he wanted to meet a man from the terminals.
Did I actually... What? Did me dying have make it die?
My home.